Its new governor proposing a long list of reforms to slash spending, among them education reform and Medicaid reform, prison reform, and plans that would require public employees to pay more for their benefits. Critics say it's a disaster. It will crush hardworking families. What's the governor say? John Kasich, the Republican, is with me now out of Columbus. And, sir, good morning to you and welcome back here. I want to move through a lot of things if I can.
Good. The first thing I got to tell you is a lot of editorial boards have been very positive about my plan, and I don't know who these critics are that say it's a disaster.
Okay, well, I'll go through a little bit of this in a moment here. But first, on the union bill, it's still in House committee. Are you surprised at that? Because the expectation we were given a few weeks ago is that this thing was going to fly right through.
Well, Bill, they're going to have a vote today, and I think it'll be voted out of committee is my understanding. But no, these things take time. You just don't zip, zip, zip. They take time, and each house has a right to be deliberative about things. And I'm very optimistic I'm going to get this bill very soon to sign.
Because it passed in the Senate again by one vote, and Republicans control both houses in Columbus. And you're saying today that you will get it done, yes?
Oh, yeah, I absolutely know it's going to get done. And what it's going to do is just rebalance. Look, when you have private sector workers paying 23% for their health care and city workers paying 9%, we got to rebalance that, Bill. That's not fair to people who go to work every day and support our government workers in terms of their pay. So it's really a rebalancing and giving local communities the tools to deal with fewer resources.
Right,
it's just plain and simple.
Right,
it's not attack on anybody. It's...
You take me right into the next category, and that is at the local level. What some are now saying is that the budget cuts, if enacted, are going to force at the local level people to raise taxes because they're going to have to make up the money from somewhere. Now is that the only solution at the local level? Because when you look at some of your Medicaid cuts, $1.4 billion on the table, you know nursing homes will take a hit because of that. What do you say to defend that move?
Well, first of all, the Medicaid packages is supported overwhelmingly by the stakeholders. The only people that are griping about it right now are some of the nursing home operators, because what we want is we want mom and dad, if they qualify for a nursing home, to be able to stay in their own home and get the help they need to stay there. Mom and dad then would be more comfortable, they'd be more independent, and the taxpayers would save a bundle of money. Outside of that, our whole Medicaid package is designed to say that we have 4% of our population drives over 50% of the cost, Bill, so we're going to coordinate their care so they get the care they need at the lowest possible price that is consistent with quality. And the bottom line is that, you know, overall, the Hospital Association, our physicians, they understand where we're going, because what we are doing in this Medicaid program is having outcome-based medicine. If you do a great job, you're going to get paid. If you do a bad job, you're not. It combines mental health with physical health, which is really important in terms of dealing with that population that drives the costs. Our Medicaid plan, in my opinion, is going to be a model for the rest of the country to take a look at how we save this kind of money yet are delivering good quality care.
That's something to watch. On education, you may have heard the debate in our last segment that Martha had about what's happening in Los Angeles. You're taking on education reform in Ohio. The Teach for America program, you're a big proponent of that. How would that help Ohio students?
Because they're sort of the best and the brightest out there, dedicating their lives to improving the math scores and the English scores and the science scores. And the fact of the matter is Teach for America improves kids' scores. They have been systematically blocked in terms of having an ability to comprehensively have a program in Ohio. I said, in my State of the State address, that Teach for America is coming to Ohio. A big chunk of the people that get educated in Ohio have to go other places to practice. They're going to be here in Ohio. It's going to happen. It's great for kids. We also want to make sure we get dollars in the classroom. Ohio's in the bottom 10 in terms of putting dollars in the classroom, and we are in the top 10 in putting dollars into red tape, administration, and overhead. We are going to change that. Okay. We're also going to give people choice. We're going to double the amount of vouchers in Ohio. We're going to lift the cap off of charter schools, but we're going to rigorously examine the charter schools so that we don't have fly-by-night operators. Bill, a lot of changes coming. Eliminating the last one in, the first one out. I'll give you an example. The last one in, the first one out, was the Teacher of the Year in Dayton. 2 weeks later, he was let go.
We're going
to improve public education
what you're doing here in Ohio.
It's going to happen.
I'm going to remember what you said about Medicaid, too, to become the model of the country. You told the Washington Post the reason we have such a reform budget is because we've been thinking about these things for a very long time, and we will visit with you again to see how things go. John Kasich in Columbus today. Thank you, Governor.
Always good to be with you.